This week's Safety Toolbox Talk is on scissors lifts and boom lifts, and we'll move closer to that boom lift in a minute. There are so many dangers involved in these lifts. Anyone using these lifts has to have proper training, either through the manufacturer, through your unions, or through your employer on how to operate these. Taking a look at this terrain, you can see what we've got going on here, right? Level that terrain. Never use a scissors lift or a boom lift out on this terrain when it's not level. And understand the ground controls. If you have an individual working up on side of the building and for some odd reason he faints or something happens to him, maybe he goes up too far and he gets caught between or crushed by a ceiling joist or something of that nature, we need to know how to control this lift from the ground level, this lift and these boom lifts to bring them down safely. But moving forward over here on some of these boom lifts, Berglund offers training every winter, typically through the manufacturer that we're going to rent from. When you're in the boom lift and you've been trained, we want to be working on level terrain as we are here and as we are over here, making sure that the gate is locked behind you and that in a boom lift it is required to be tied off. Now, back in the fall, a couple of superintendents and I went to some training in Houston, Texas with gentlemen that are authors of the ANSI standards, the American National Safety Institute, and they were actually expressing the best practice for boom lifts. And it is no longer a retractable, because when you get bounced out of a basket, the retractable is tied off below your shoulders and you're over the basket edge, and that top rail may fool the retractable and feed the entire retractable out. So they're asking us to go back to the best practice, which is shock-absorbing lanyards for boom lifts, not necessarily a requirement by the manufacturer of a scissors lift yet anyway, as far as being tied off in. Also a best practice is moving these genie lifts, these boom lifts, from point A to, say, point B. At that point in time, a 6-foot shock-absorbing lanyard, it may bounce you out of that apparatus if the terrain is unlevel. They're actually expressing the interest in using a positioning device when you're moving it from point A to point B. Keeping in mind, when you move a boom lift, you snorkel in and bring the boom down and then move it. Do not move a boom lift while you're up in the air and you're extended outward. And then another catch with boom lifts and scissors lifts is when you're going up, are there power lines in the vicinity? And if so, we need to stay 10 feet away from them, power lines. But also, if there's an existing roof truss system over your head, do not continue going upward and crush yourself in that caught between pinch by exposure that's taking so many construction lives a year. These are very dangerous. We're supposed to be helping each other out, understanding what training we need, understanding the task, understanding the terrain, understanding how to get that man down if by chance he's not capable of getting down on his own. So this week, let's talk about scissors and boom lift. And if you have not had the training, you have no right to be on any of these lifts. As an employer, we cannot allow that. So please understand that. Let's have a safe week.